Hey there, I'm going to try to explain how to shift an 18-speed. This model here, it's in a new Peterbilt 389. It's an Eaton, very common 18-speed. Personally, it's my favorite. You know, they got 8, 10, and 13. You know, they're all good transmissions, especially with this little device here where you can kind of split a gear and whatnot. Now, how to identify an 18-speed, just take a good look at the design there. See the top left there, you know, reverse high low, bottom left low, and you can just see, you know, straight up one in the middle, you know, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. All right, so that's a very common design of an 18 speed. All right, okay, I'm just going to explain it real quickly. I'm just parked here. So anyway, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, and you're asking yourself, well, why is it 18? Okay. Low is 2, and then 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Man, doesn't that blow you away? You're like, oh my God, what? How am I going to shift like this, okay? All right, just relax. It's not that complicated. And when you start driving these 18 speeds, you know, probably within a half day or a day, you're going to get addicted to this split in the gear right here. And you don't have to shift as much going up hills and accelerating on the freeway and whatnot, okay? Anyway, in the top left position, you can see that's reverse, okay? And reverse low, you know, your selector's down, okay? And if you want to go a little faster, like if you're in a big parking lot at Walmart and you got to go, you know, just in reverse, maybe a little faster, you can flip this up and there's a little higher speed, you know, in the reverse position. But you know what, if you're a new driver or whatnot, just take your time. There's never a reason to haul ass in reverse, okay? But you can if you flip the switch up while it's in the reverse position, okay? Low, of course, you know, if you got a big load there and you're just, you know, on a hill or you feel comfortable where you need to start in the low position, it's the bottom left, okay? And there's a high low there as well, okay? And It's the same exact thing as the reverse gear, okay? Boom, boom. Now, when this selector's down, that's always the low position, okay? And then when you go upward, you know, it's kind of like shifting up one gear, all right? I think that the more you drive, you're going to find out that you're always going to be starting pretty much in first gear most of the time, all right? So what I'll do is I'll just explain real quickly how 18 speeds, you know, fly by if you're just accelerating from an intersection or maybe getting on an on-ramp, okay? Okay, obviously first gear is right there in the middle, okay, in the low position. So this, you can see this is going to be back, and then this is going to be in the down position. So down, and the side selector is back, okay? So first gear, you'll let out the clutch. Second gear, you know, you're only going a couple miles an hour. You know, and this is, let's just say you're accelerating from a flat intersection. All right, you go into third gear, you go into fourth gear, and then when you go into fifth gear, you know, you're going to flip up your selector, and you're going to go in the middle there. You can see 5. And if you want to go down to 6, 7, and 8, you know, obviously you're going to keep your selector up. Okay, so there's just 8 speeds, and you're not even splitting the gear yet, okay? And like I said, I'll explain how it gets to a total of 18 gears. All right. So if you're new and you're kind of intimidated by an 18 speed, just remember, you don't even have to touch this. Just, you know, get comfortable. Just drive and be safe. Just go through 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You know, keep your selector, you know, up, you know, low for your lower gears and up for your upper gears. And, you know, just get to know your shift pattern. Okay. Now, now splitting the gears, you can see this right here, okay? When it's back, it's not in the split position. And when you go forward, see, and all you do is just flip it, see? When you flip it forward, it shifts without actually shifting the stick itself. And it gives you like an extra few hundred RPM. So if you're going up a hill or whatnot, sometimes you're just like, let's just say you're in sixth gear, okay? Your selector's up and this is back. Well, if you don't want to shift the stick itself, go ahead and just let off the throttle, flip it forward, and this is if you're in sixth gear, so it's almost going like 6.5, all right? All you do is just your throttle's down, and when you let off the throttle, flip this forward, give the throttle gas again, you know, or, you know, press it, not gas, but you guys know what I mean. And it'll automatically shift into an upper gear. It's splitting the gear, and excuse me, and you don't have to shift this stick itself, okay? So you're in sixth gear, all the way down, selector's up, of course, and this is forward. Okay, now to go into seventh gear, what you're gonna do is you're gonna flip this backwards, and you're gonna shift into the upright position. All right, accelerate a little bit. And if you wanna split the gear, not actually shift down to the bottom right into eighth, if you're in seventh, go ahead. You know, you got the throttle down, lift up, go like this, let the throttle off, give it throttle again, and it's like shifting. It's like going into seven and a half gears, okay? Or in eight, so to speak. All right, and like I said, when you split the gear like this, you don't have to actually move the stick itself. Okay, so let's just say we're going like 20 miles an hour, we're flat at an intersection, and we're just going up to like 55 miles an hour, let's say. Okay, you're in sixth gear, which would be your selector up, and this is back. Okay, six, to go into six and a half, so to speak, or into seventh without actually moving it. Okay, you're in the bottom. All you do is let off the throttle, flip it forward. It'll shift again without moving the stick. Okay. And then if you want to go up to seventh, remember, flip this back and then go up into the seventh gear. And then if you want like two or three more, RPM without shifting the stick, just go ahead, let off the throttle, go forward, let it off again, and the truck will automatically shift without the stick itself, okay? So when you go from seventh, you know, basically I like to call it seven and a half gears, you know, just if you're new to an 18 speed, you know, you just kind of explain it in simple terms. If you want to go down to eighth gear, flip it back, put the shifter down into the bottom right into eighth, and if you're accelerating, go ahead and just let off the throttle, let this go forward, give it the throttle again, and you'll feel the truck shift. Now sometimes you kind of like you're messing around and you do it too fast. If you go like this without bumping the throttle, nothing will happen. You know, just flip it back, let off the throttle, go like this, flip it forward, okay, boom, and then give it the throttle again, and you'll get really good at just feeling the truck shift without actually moving the stick itself, okay? And low gear is one and two. First gear, okay, is three. And then when you split it, there's four. When you go to second gear, that's five. Split it, six. Third gear, seven. Split it, eight. Fourth gear, nine. Split it, 10. Okay. Then you go back up to fifth gear. And that's 11. Split it, 12. Sixth gear, 13. Split it, 14. Seventh gear, 15. Split it, 16. Eighth gear, 17. And when you split it, there's 18. Okay? So remember, you know, and when you're going in reverse, you got low and high. And you decide, most people are always going to go in reverse in the low selector, so the selector's down, and this will always be back. When you try to shift a lot and you accidentally leave this forward, all right, the truck will shift kind of weird. It'll feel kind of gutless or kind of sputtering a little bit. You know, if you can't figure it out, just go, oh, God, you know what? I left the splitter forward. And like I said, the more you drive this thing, you're going to love the 18 speed. All right, and hopefully I'm explaining it a little better. I know I'm kind of all over the place. Just rewatch this video a few times, but just relax. If you're brand new to an 18 speed, just don't even mess with this splitter. Just get real good at going through the gears. All right, you guys probably know how to do a manual already if you're watching this, you know, but there's your low gears and there's your upper gears. Okay, and how to identify an 18 speed, that's the most common with an Eaton tranny, okay? All right, the low there is on the top left, or I'm sorry, the reverse, and then the low is on the bottom left. But just look at that. Okay, 13 speeds, 10, 8 speeds, they're all kind of similar, but if this plate is bone stock from Eaton, you know, they have their own different design and whatnot. But like I said, the hardest part is probably just getting in it. Don't be scared of the tranny. You're not going to blow it up. Nothing's going to happen. Even if you're going down the freeway and you accidentally go like this and nothing happens, don't worry. The tranny's not going to blow up. All right. So if you're just cruising, let's say you're going like 55 miles an hour, you know, let's say you're in eighth gear, your selector will be up and this will be back. So if you're, let's just say you're in seventh, all right, the top right position. All right, let's say you're going 50 miles an hour and you want to go 55. Let off the throttle, shift that forward, and the truck will automatically shift without moving the stick. And then remember, when you want to go down into the eighth position, the bottom right, just go ahead and put this back, shift it down to the bottom right. And if you want to split the gear, just go a little faster, you know, a little more RPM. Just go ahead and let off the throttle, push that forward. Push the throttle again and you'll feel the truck do like a half shift. And it's really nice. You're going to really love this transmission, especially if you're going uphill or you just need to pass someone real quick. If you're going like 60 and you just need to go up to like 64 or 65 real quick just to get around. But, you know, when you're topped out on the freeway, you're going to be in the bottom right position there where it says number 8. You know, your selector is going to be up. And then more than likely, if you're on a flat surface, go ahead and shift it all the way up, and that'll get you your lowest RPM and probably your best fuel mileage. But there's a lot of times where the freeway is just a little bit of an incline, and you just don't have a, you know, it just feels like it's kind of lugging a little bit. But if you shift this back and you're in top gear, you know, it gives you a little bit more RPM, and the engine just sounds great. It's just singing along, okay? But like I said, you're not going to break the tranny, just splitting the shift, you know, just relax. You know, and you're going to love it, man. I'll tell you, you'll be on the freeway in no time. And like I said, sometimes when you go ahead and shift it forward or backward, you don't get a response. Just go ahead, relax, bump the throttle again, just push it a little bit, and you'll feel the transmission either shift up or down just by going like this, okay? And that's it. So anyway, hopefully this kind of explains a little bit. I'm not that great at these tutorial videos. I'm just sitting here in a parking lot real quick. And like I said, this is basically how you shift an 18 speed. Just play around with it. If the company you work for, if you have your own truck, just go in a parking lot, go on the freeway, and just practice backing up, going forward, and everything. And before you know it, in an hour, you'll love this. Splitting the gears is just the best idea in the world. And an 18 speed, I think, is just by far the best transmission if you're going to go manual. So, all right, guys. Okay, take it easy. All right, thanks.